sent out an updated version of the what color to wear for BYU fans to each football game, home and road games.
Hit me.
Let's start on August 29th with the season opener against Utah. Shocker, they want fans to wear royal.
Of course. Now, what's cool is when the Deseret First Credit Union, the Deseret Duel started, when BYU and Utah play in basketball and football, they wear royal and crimson.
Ooh.
Always. That juxtaposition is awesome.
Oh, it looks amazing.
Love it.
It really looks nice.
Yeah.
Okay. Royal is the same color.
Well, one of them look nice.
Royal is the same color for the first road game at Tennessee. So two royal games to open things up.
Okay. Then that royal will really pop against the orange.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, that'd
be
great.
This is well played.
Yeah.
This is well played by athletics
well
in the BYU store.
Well played, Mauer.
Mm-hmm. BYU goes navy for fan color in the home game against USC, and then a whiteout against Washington the week after.
Ooh, I like that. End of September, whiteout. Getting a little cooler.
Okay. Then there is another royal effort at Toledo in the Glass Bowl. You want the royal to show up in the Glass Bowl in Toledo, Ohio.
I think they're kind of navy-ish, so yeah, you got to pop in some way.
BYU then goes on the road to Tampa for a game at USF, and this is a road whiteout, if you will. So
Florida BYU fans show up. Yeah, it's like, you know, the white pants, Miami Vice thing. You're in Florida, wear white. I like it.
I will wear white pants while I'm in Florida.
Do it.
That's going to happen. Then BYU returns home for the rivalry game against Boise State on October 19th, and they go back-to-back royal games, hosting the Broncos in that Mountain West duo, and then they go to Utah State after a bye in Logan wearing royal once again.
Royal. Interesting. How does Utah State feel about the royal? Because they always claim that BYU like stole that. Well, they wear navy now, though, right?
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
So, again, you want your fans to stick out.
We're not saying that BYU is wearing this for a jersey. They haven't revealed that quite yet.
They can do what they want.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, they do what they want.
This is what the fans are going to wear.
Now, November 9th, BYU comes home to host Liberty, who I believe is a majority red color, and they will wear the Cougars. We'll wear navy.
Okay.
Idaho State.
The Cougar fans.
Home finale. Cougar fans will wear royal. So that makes
5, 6
royal games thus far against this one, including Idaho State.
Yeah.
Then BYU will go with Navy at UMass and Royal to close things out at San Diego State.
The Royal and Senior Day as well. Idaho State.
Correct.
Okay. Okay, interesting.
Seven royal games.
One thing that's important to understand in all this is, I think that people get caught up in the, isn't Navy the primary? Why can't Royal be the primary? There are two primaries. It's Navy and Royal. Do you remember when you were younger and you'd go into your closet in the morning and you'd grab something to go to school and your mom would say, no, that doesn't match. That does not apply anymore. Like, any kid can wear any color sock with any shoe, any shirt. That's the style right now. So guess what? If BYU wears Royal with the fans, but they wear Navy on the field or whatever, they don't match. What? White, Royal, Navy, these are the colors, right? These are the colors.
We all love the uniforms, but let's be honest. When you look at a stadium, you want the stadium to pop. And Royal or White typically just pops more as a fan base.
The only time you really get everybody in the same color,
white,
is if you have a crazy rich tradition where that's what happens, or you give them shirts. That, like, in the playoffs in the NBA, it feels like every team is like, boom, Warriors, we wear these yellow shirts. People aren't showing up in their yellow shirts. They're wearing the one you give them, right? So hopefully Cougar fans can jump on board, but the most effective way to do that is, hey, Rock, here's the shirts, right? That's generally how it works. But if you're going on the road, this is good because you want some unification, right? Cougar Nation shows up, boom, in the same color.
And I know there was a little bit of frustration to some end that there would be no blackout. Hey, I don't think it's a mystery that BYU athletic director Tom Holmoe
is... It wasn't black in a while.
He's not super keen on breaking out of the traditional colors. BYU is one of those old school traditional brands, like royal, white, a little bit of navy. It's just with that stretch white helmet, this is how it's going
to
be.
Well, there's been more royal. We choose to use royal, by the way, on this show, if you've ever noticed.
So does BYU athletics.
Yeah, they use a lot of royal. If you look at the social media, right, you can have two primary colors, royal and navy.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
What, does that mean BYU is going to wear a royal uniform a ton? We'll see.
No. Yeah. What we did see on equipment handout day or equipment preparation day is that BYU does have white jerseys with royal numerals, and blue royal pants with white stripes down the side, which is a throwback to their old road uniforms in the 80s and 90s.
I want the mesh, dude.
Oh, you want the mesh.
With McMahon, it's just like, you know, it's like a penny when you're playing pickup. Or hey. I'm just kidding. Those are the worst.
You know what uniform I want? I want the 1996 Nike uniform, BYU blue, with the black drop shadow on the white. That would be the ultimate throwback. Shadow. That would be the ultimate
just
throwback.
Just bring back the bibs then.
No.
Dude, if BYU did
you're
the
comparing
bibs
the
one game, that would be awesome.
Okay, one game, yes.
One game, just one game. So it could all be like, these are so gross.
Yes.
Like, the Pittsburgh Steelers do the Bumblebee one.
So ugly.
So bad, but it's funny. It's whatever.
They were like these cream pants and then black and yellow tops. Like, you want to talk about things that
even
don't match?
Even Wyoming thinks that's gross.
The things that don't match? Oh, it's so bad.
Yeah.
But yeah, like a one game, like, that. This it's the 96 jersey day. It's the bib day.
Yeah, like, if BYU ever plays UTEP or Tulsa at home, it's just like old whack, late 90s garbage, right? Like, 98. 99, they would have been in the Mountain West. So say it's like 97, it's 96-ish, almost bibs. You know, you could have a lot of fun there.
I love it.
I would love if BYU wore black again at some point in the future. It doesn't look like that's the case for this year. I think if BYU were wearing it, they might have announced it by now because the fans get excited. You remember when the basketball team wore black at New Mexico?
Nobody was doing it back then, though.
It was so cool. The Bulls in 96, when they've won 72 games, had this third jersey that was black. They'd wear on the road
with pinstripes.
Yes, it was so awesome. Part of that is that it was MJ, right? Wearing it. Uncle Mike, as I call him. I wish that BYU had a black jersey along those lines in basketball.
Jason Shepard just sent Jerem and I a message that said, I want a tan out. Tan, would you ever bring back any tan?
There are no dumb ideas. They're just dumb people with ideas. Okay? A tan out would be the worst.
That's the equivalent of the Bumblebee jerseys for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Well,
those pants.
Well, you know, we pointed this out a couple years ago. On the sidelines, the quarterbacks were wearing, when it was cold, those big coats that go head to toe. And they had the old school
tan accents
logo.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I thought, how have they not made a new one?
It's time for new coats, guys.
Yeah.
And they got them.
Yeah. I can't remember how many. We're getting to the point on this show. This is our seventh football season that we're covering, where I can't differentiate between 2 and 3 years ago and 6 years ago. It's getting to that point. We're like, when was that?
All right. You've got 7 Royal games.
7 is a lot.
2 white games. 3 Navy games.
Yeah. Okay. Let's
get your clothing while you can, BYU store.
Well, they're all white games.
It's all available, also online.
Yeah.
But really, just make sure you have Royal by August 29th.
If you're a BYU fan.
Countdown to the Utes.
28 days. 4 weeks from today.
Number 28, Pete Van Valkenburg. Can we talk about him for a sec?
Yes, please.
In 1972, he led the nation in rushing from BYU. Pete Van Valkenburg.
Now, this is ironic because BYU had just implemented their drop back pass attack.
No, they would the next year. They obviously didn't if they had the nation's leading rusher. The next year, they bring in this JC kid named Gary Scheide. So when Gary comes on a recruiting visit, they say, yeah, we're going to put in this passing attack. He goes, really? I'm seeing you got this guy that's leading the country in rushing. Are you serious? Your boy, Gary Scheide, wins the Sammy Baugh for best quarterback the next year.
Incredible.
How about that?
Drafted by my Cincinnati Bengals.
Yeah.
What's up, Gary?
Yeah.
Let's go,
I was
going to
say, if you're a BYU fan, you don't own Royal anything, come on. Are you even a BYU fan? Let's go.